pretty crazy to see what that tropical storm did here. And we're thinking of our friends there in Central America with a Category 5 headed their way, Bobby.
Just a tropical storm, and it did all the damage here that it did. Imagine if it was a Cat 1. It was a Cat 1 at one point, but just offshore. And now it's a Cat 5. This is the strongest one that we've seen of the season, likely to be the end of it, at least for the most part. 919 is pressure, 160 mile per hour winds. Now, I wanted to show you, this is a visible satellite. You see we're losing a little bit of the view. You can look right down there in the eye. This is the track that the Hurricane Center thinks it's going to go on. This blue line is where Eta just went less than 2 weeks ago. Hundreds were missing from mudslides and the flooding from Eta. And now, less than 2 weeks ago, they have even a stronger hurricane coming over them. This is northeastern parts of Nicaragua, Honduras up to the north here. The forecast track, as you can see, does bring it just straight to the west. Remember, Eta came through and then kind of did one of these things and then up to the north and the east. Forecast models on this are not doing that. It'll weaken. It'll come back out over towards the Pacific side, and it will not be an issue for the United States. But man, oh man, those people are really going to need some help. Now, there is another wave that we're watching. In fact, it's going to be some lower pressures developing here by, maybe Wednesday into Thursday. You can see here's our storm here. But there's about a 40% chance that this develops. And the modeling was taken towards Costa Rica, which is right down in here. Although the latest runs haven't done too much with it. So 40% chance that would be by Wednesday into Thursday. Could be a landfall Friday night or so in the Costa Rican area if that were to form. Look at all these storms, guys. 30 storms to get through Iota. Kappa is the next name in the Greek alphabet that we would use if we get there.